National Church Life Survey tells us that most Australians don't even know a Christian. So to reach this country with the gospel, we've got some work to do. The best strategy to reach people is to start new churches. New churches reach new people. Every church in this country began as a church plant with energy and vision and so on. We just forget that because we built them out of sandstone and stained glass. What we need is a whole new generation of church planters to bring new churches into existence that will reach new people.
We're certainly taking church planting really seriously. We see that there are so many people who aren't being reached, and we've started something in our home, putting our resources behind that, so that people can come and look at the Bible and be challenged by Jesus openly.
Geneva Push is an Australian church planting network that's dedicated to helping to recruit, assess and inspire a whole new generation of church planters who will go out and evangelise new churches into existence.
Vine Church started in 2011 with the simple idea of reaching the city with the gospel of Jesus. Surrey Hills, which is where we're based, is an area which attracts lots of different kinds of people, professionals, artists and musicians, social workers and people escaping the suburb because of broken relationships. Geneva has inspired us to keep thinking about reaching the entire of Australia with the gospel. Rather than just planting one church, we want to be a church that goes on to plant more and more churches so that we reach Australia. Because of the investment Geneva has made in myself and Vine Church, I'm fully convinced that we wouldn't be where we are today without their encouragement, assessment and training they've provided us.
To get a church plant to work, you've got to have a bunch of things in place. You need to have someone who's got the gospel. So there's our, we want to inspire guys, we've heard about that. We need to actually then get guys who are supported, but also equipped. We want to make sure that men who go out with a passion, a vigour and energy, prayerfully, have actually just the mechanics of how to do church planting. Are kept encouraged and supported in the way they think about the strategies, the nuts and bolts. How do I do a Bible ministry in a contextual situation? How do I resource this work? How do I break growth barriers? You've got a whole bunch of equipping thing that just needs to happen to help men have the best kind of chance under God to make it fire. One of the big things that it compelled us to get this whole thing rolling was a desire to get the few of us who were church planting around the country together, so that instead of a few of us in outposts on our own doing our own little bit, we can actually come, we could fire, we could encourage and nurture. But alongside that, we do a bunch of stuff to facilitate that. So the conferences we run at the end of each year, we have the Australian Church Planting Conference, where we call it Multiply, get everyone together, get some good Bible teaching, get stirred up, get equipped, get inspired and so on. We've got a website, a whole lot of resources there. We just keep pumping resource into it, new church planting ideas. People are talking about what they're doing. It all goes up on the website. We're running webinars. So monthly there's a new topic that's run through the website. Geneva's been a real gift in that we've seen 96 church planters assisted throughout the country. We've seen men who have been starting churches previously that we've got alongside and supported, but we've also together with that got 42 new churches, supporting new churches going, which is across every denomination, into Presbyterians, into Anglicans, into Baptists, it's astonishing. Our hope is by 2015 to get 100 churches started.
Now I planted my church just about 5 years ago, and Geneva Push didn't exist back then, and there was no one else doing assessments in Australia. Really, it's an objective way of measuring whether you have what it takes to be able to go through the rigors of a church plant. There are many risks with church planting, both personally and corporately and spiritually and as a family and as a couple. And those are just the ways in which, I guess, it doesn't take all of the risks out, but it gives you a better idea whether these are measured risks or not. And also, if this is something you ought to be doing, then it's a great encouragement, because other people have said, in a sort of objective way, hey, you know, we think you've got what it takes. There are people that I have my eye on within my ministries. I would absolutely encourage them to be assessed. I think it's invaluable.
It's not enough just to assess a church planter. All you've then told them is that they and those around them will know they might have what it takes to start a church. You need to then equip them with resources and relationships to get the job done. And then we want to unleash them and run alongside them to support them and equip them as they go. The coaching relationship is really key. It provides the vision, the support, gives access to resources and people that the planter can use and keep them encouraged along the whole way. But then no one coach can do everything. And so being a part of a network of relationships means that planters can draw on a whole range of people who can help them in this really tough work.
New Life Anglican Church is a brand new church plant, begun a year and a half ago with my associate pastor and our wives. We're here to reach people who are young families predominantly and also those of retirement age, and we're really enjoying seeing the church grow. I've really benefited from the coaching that I've received at Geneva. In essence, it becomes a living Wikipedia of church planning. You get to chat with a guy who's older and wiser, who's walked the path ahead of you, ask the questions that you don't know the answers to that they might understand or have some insight on. In essence, coaching helps us feel like we're not on our own.
The kind of support that Geneva provides for church planting couples and families is one of the things that really makes me and my wife Nikki excited about Geneva. Having been involved in starting churches without that kind of support, we know how painful it can be and how valuable the encouragement, the spiritual strengthening, the friendships can really be. Things such as the Refresh Conference Geneva does every year are just priceless. Geneva can't do much to actually make sure churches get started all around the country. We're not a church, we're not a denomination. But we can inspire people with a vision of the gospel of Christ being known in the cities and the country and connect people to one another. And I think if that starts to happen, all sorts of things will take place around the country.
We've got 22 million people who need to be reached. We want to have churches that can break out and keep growing and growing and be grounded the whole time.
This is a huge job and we just really need people to come on board and help us.
There's many different ways to help us. One of the simplest ways to give financially is to go to the website and donate, or you can contact us through the website and ask for more information.